Mr. R wanted us to learn, and I, David,
I,
from his fourth period chemistry, have learned to an A
and a C
level the following concepts from the first 11 chapters of our chemistry book. This is not an inclusive list, but my selection of concepts from each chapter that I will remember. In chapter 1, Introduction to Chemistry, I learned that the scientific method is a systematic approach to solving a problem, and the five steps are making observations, testing hypotheses, and developing theories. Those would fall under them.
And I learned an effective way to solve problems involves developing a plan and implementing that plan.
In chapter 2, Matter and Change, I learned that there are two properties used to describe matter, and those properties are extensive properties and intensive properties.
I also learned that there are three states of matter, and they are solids, liquids, and gases.
Chapter 3, Scientific Measurement. I learned that scientific notation is used so that large numbers are easy to work with and so they don't get messed up.
And I learned that there are five SI base units used by chemists. They are known as the meter, kilogram, Kelvin, second, and mole.
Chapter 4, Atomic Structure. I learned that the atomic numbers of elements are based on how many protons that element has.
And Democritus thought atoms were indivisible and indestructible.
And then for chapter 5, Electrons and Atoms, I learned that the orbitals arranged in the nuclei of atoms are called electron configurations.
Also, the Bohr model says electrons are found in orbitals around the nucleus.
Chapter 6, The Periodic Table. I learned that Mendeleev created his periodic table by placing the elements in order of increasing atomic mass.
And the group 1A elements are alkaline metals, alkaline earth metals, and halogens.
And then for chapter 7, ionic and metallic bonding, I learned that atoms share electrons to attain a noble gas configuration.
And metal atoms...
Oh, I read the wrong one. Valence electrons are the electrons that are in the highest occupied energy level.
And metal atoms are arranged in very compact patterns.
And then, chapter 8, covalent bonding, atoms share electrons to attain a noble gas configuration.
And there can be triple or double pair bonds.
Chapter 9, chemical names and formulas. The names of most of polyatomic ions end in ite or ate.
And to name a compound using a polyatomic ion, you first write the cation and then the anion.
Chapter 10, chemical quantities. I learned that Avogadro's number is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power.
Also, the atomic mass of an element in grams is the same as the mass of a mole of the element.
Chapter 11, chemical reactions. I learned that the five types of reactions are combustion, decomposition, combination, single replacement, and double replacement.
Well, I learned a net ionic equation shows only those particles involved in the reaction.
That's what we learned
in the first semester of chemistry.
Yay!